righteous, faithful, grace and mercy. And we see in this story, and I'm not going to read it all, and I'm not going to go all into the details of it, but we see where God has given a young man by the name of Joshua an appointment.
All right.
An assignment. That he's given him something to carry out that Moses didn't carry out. So if God is saying it's the people that he told to do some stuff.
All right.
And they didn't complete it or didn't do it. But God said, I got somebody that I can raise up to do what I need to be done.
Yeah.
So this is what he did with Joshua. Not knowing that he had Joshua walking with Moses, because he said he was his aide, was training him to do what it is that he needed done. So this is what God has said to us, that I put you with some people. Minister King, training, because I need to send you out to do an assignment that somebody else didn't do. So we just thank God today that even though Joshua, he didn't tell God no, but he said, okay, I'm going to do what you told me to do. But Joshua had to have some courageous faith.
Yeah.
He had to have some courageous faith because he had seen a lot of stuff walking with Moses. He saw how people rebuked Moses and how people stood up against Moses, how people didn't obey Moses. He saw all of this and he was like, Lord, you telling me to do this? To lead your people. Now not just anybody's people, but to lead your people into the promised land. And what God is doing, he is calling Leah Deliverance Ministry to lead his people into the promised land.
Joshua.
But y'all know what? We got to have some courageous faith. We got to have some grace. We got to have some grace and some mercy for this job. Because it's not easy leading people. It's not easy telling people what God said, because they'll come up against you.
Yeah.
They'll begin to say, God didn't tell you to tell me that. God didn't tell us to do this. But we got to have some courageous faith. God told Joshua three times. He said, have faith. Be strong and courageous.
Yeah.
Then he said, be very courageous. So we got to be strong in this season, because the enemy is going to come. But we got to stand and be strong, and we got to believe what God has told us to do. Joshua, a young man. A young man, but full of faith. But I like God, because God, he don't tell you to do something and won't bring anybody in to help you, because when I was reading, I saw Caleb's name in the story.
Help, help.
So God said, I'll send some Caleb's doesn't read a see your vision. Not question what God say. Not question what God tell you to do. But say, okay, I'm with you. We can do this. God is with us. Like God had already told Joshua. He said, I am with you.
Yeah.
God had already encouraged Joshua before Joshua started encouraging himself.
Yeah, talk.
Because some things came up against Joshua. And that's why Joshua had to stop, because he remembered Jesus encouraging him, telling him, God telling him what to do. And then he had to stop and say, I'll just encourage myself. The reason why I can talk about Joshua, because when God told me to come up here and start in this church and start doing this work, I had to stop. I'm always encouraging people. I'm always telling people what God said, what they do. I be like, Lord, who praying for me? Who gonna send me a word? Who gonna encourage me when I need? Did nobody stop by here and say, keep on praying, keep on doing what God said to do? Did nobody encourage me? And one day I was in here, I got discouraged. I got discouraged. I said, Lord, what's going on? I'm at a standstill. I was starting, everything would be flowing and moving, and then he'll stop me. I said, Lord, what's going on? I said, Lord, now the encourager needs to be encouraged.
Yeah.
So I stopped and I said, I'll be like Joshua. I'll just encourage myself. And I just kept on. I just kept on working. I just kept on praying. I just kept on believing God. And he'll bring some people to say, don't worry, you ain't got to try to complete everything. That's what my mama would tell. She said, you don't have to try to do everything.
everywhere.
That the soles of your feet tread, and you can possess the land. So everywhere that our feet go, that's the key. When we start getting out into projects, we're going to possess the land. By His grace and by His mercy, we're going to possess the fellow.
Yes, sir.
God said, courageous faith. Believe it. Before you see. Joshua Solomon had the promised land in view of what God was saying. Who God, but it ain't nothing like when you enter into.
Yeah.
It's nothing like when you enter into the promised land. God has given us the promised land, but when are we going to get to? When are we going to walk in prosperity? When are we going to walk in success? Where are we going to walk in happiness? Where are we going to walk in joy? Where are we going to possess the land?
My God.
He's given us a land of plenty.
Yes,
and everything that we need, He said, is in.
Yes. My God.
It's in. It's in.
Yes.
But Joshua could get it standing still. Caleb was there to say, I'm with you. Just like Jesus said, I'm with you. He said, I sent Minister King to be with you. I sent Minister Don to be with you. I sent Hassan to be with you. I'm sending some people to be with you. That they're going to see the vision. That you all are going to walk into the promised land. That you all are going to eat the good of the land. And I like that, but he said, and told him, you got to obey me though.
Obey.
You got to obey me. Before you can eat the good of the land.
Yeah.
See, we can't eat good. We can eat some stripes if we want to. But when we start obeying God, He said we can eat the good of the land. We won't have to be like the woman that was eating the crumb from the master's table. We'll eat at the master's table.
Yes.
Because we obey God. I tell y'all, God showed us so bad in Atlanta, Georgia, Friday night. He cleared out a whole restaurant for us. When nobody left in it but us. Told us to take our time. Told us we didn't have to be in a hurry. He waited on us. Cleared out a whole restaurant. He said, I told you, you'll find favor with me
and
with me.
Yes, sir.
I mean, He cleared out a whole restaurant. We was in that praying and had a church all by ourselves. Because we obeyed God. Because we obeyed God. Because we had some courageous faith to step out on faith. To go do what God said to. Because we had some courageous faith. And because of His amazing grace. His grace and mercy took us to Atlanta, Georgia. His grace and mercy brought us back home. His grace, I said, get out of Moshe Yada. And His mercy is sufficient for us all, if we obey, if we obey, if we obey. God gave me three words. Then He showed me what Joshua was. And He showed me that this is what we will be. And this is what we is, because He wouldn't have called us. He wouldn't have called us if we wasn't. He showed me that Joshua was committed. Joshua was committed. And see, that's why God can't send in and everybody into this ministry, because I've been committed to God for years.
Amen.
I've been committed to doing what He told me to do. And then number one come, then number two come, I was still committed to do what God said do. God is calling us to the front line to lead this generation into His presence.
Amen.
But we can't lead them if we're not committed.
That's right.
We gotta be committed to do whatever it takes. To saturate ourselves with the Word of God, no matter what the circumstances look like.
Yeah.
We got to be committed. If this church don't never fill up, we still got to be committed to come out here and teach Sunday school. I still got to get up here and be committed to pray. But I just believe God, because we committed, He's going to send the people that we're going to eat the good of the land. Joshua was committed to obey God. And then I saw that he was courageous. He had some courageous faith. Some courageous faith that no matter what he was looking at, he said, I believe God. Because God has already told me that He's with me. So I'm just going to believe God that no matter what it is, I'm going to believe that he's with me, because he said, I'm the same yesterday, today, and forever. So he's telling me God don't change. Joshua could have changed. He could have said, I'm not going to do this. He could have, because I know he got discouraged. I know he got discouraged, but because Jesus, God had already given him what he needed, told him he was equipped. He sent me a word by a young lady. Told me, said, I was praying for you all night, because I was struggling with this thing. She said, but God said, he's already equipped you. He has already equipped you for this. I've already given you everything and everybody you don't need to do what I told you to do. But I just have to keep on, I just have to keep on having that courageous faith. I just have to keep on believing that I'm going to do what God said to. Because he said he's the same yesterday, today, and forever. And then I saw something else in Joshua there. Joshua was consistent. Even though he got discouraged, he kept on moving. He kept on following the plans of God. He kept on doing what God told him to do. He was consistent, and that's what we got to do. We got to be consistent in season and out of season, no matter what it looked like, no matter what it feel like, no matter who called, no matter who go. We got to be consistent in our faith.
Yeah.
We got to be consistent in what we're believing God for.
Talk, daughter.
We got to be consistent at doing what God has told us to do, not giving up, not fraying, not falling to the side, not stumbling, but being consistent in doing what God said do. Because once we are consistent, God shows up.
Amen.
He said, oh, I can't just keep sitting here, because I see they're going to do it regardless. I see that's just like when your kids, children, you know, when you ask your parents for something, and they said no the first time, and you just keep on coming back and say, Mama, can I? And you just keep on being consistent with the thing. My son used to do me like that all the time. He would just keep on, Mama, can I borrow your car? Mama, can I get some money? Mama, can I? And he just keep on. So eventually, I gave him, and I gave him what he was asking me for. So this is what God said, if we be consistent and coming out here, doing what he said to me, guess what he's going to do? He's getting ready to give us what we're asking him for.
Thank you.
Because we have been committed.
Oh, yeah.
We was courageous. Just radical. God said it's time for us to get radical for him. It's time to just let out. Read God's word. You got to be messing up my hair wide tonight and staring tonight. And I got to get up and preach on Sunday. But he said, that's okay, because I'm going to be radical for God. I'll put on a hat, a wig, a weave, or whatever. But I'm going to do what God said to me. Because if you come in here pretty, I'm sorry, you're in the wrong place. Because before you leave out here, you might not have no curls. The clothes might be soaking wet. Because we are some courageous, we are some committed and consistent people of God. So I thank God for Joshua being committed, being courageous, and being consistent to pursue. Ah, see, that's what we got to do. We got to pursue. We got to pursue. We got to run after. We got to go after what it is that God is telling us to do. We got to get in a hurry to do it. Minister King was sharing with me, God said, urgency, urgency. This is an urgency needed in this area, that God will raise up some Joshua and some Caleb to do his will. We got to pursue, because this is our purpose. The reason why it's in us, because it's purpose.
Yeah.
It's our purpose.
Right.
It's our purpose.
Yes.
And that's why we're pursuing it. That's why it's, we just can't sit down. That's why we just can't let people discourage us, because this is our